Today we will learn about the second chapter, that is GUI introduction, GUI operating system introduction. We will understand about the operating system. What is operating system? Operating system means controls the all the activities of computer, all the activities of computer, that is operating system. It act like as a principal of the school. Principal of the school. Principal also controls the all the activities of the school. Same things here also in computer. Operating system is a big software that controls all the activities of computer. Thus, an operating system can be defined as a set of computer programs that helps the computer to operate smoothly. It is a system software designed to support all the activities of computer system. I will tell the some functions of operating system. Some functions having the operating systems, just I will discuss about this one also. The diff page number 23, page number 23. It interact with the hardware and software. Operating system, it interact with the hardware and software. Interact means make the communication of between hardware and software. Second one, it coordinates and assigns the task to the software. Operating system giving to the some soft job work to the software. Third one, it interrupts the command and instructions. Computers operating by the commands also. That's why interrupts the commands and instructions. Instructions make the rules. Rules make the programs. And lot of programs make the software. And next one, it detects the error present in the system. Operating systems, whatever the errors are coming in that system, that time, that error find detects at same time only. An operating system provides two different type of environment for the users. We are the users. We are using the computer. That's why we are the users. First one, command user interface, that is DOS environment. Second one, graphical user interface, that is the environment, Windows environment. Now we will learn about the CUI and GUI. What is the main difference of CUI and GUI? We know already that CUI means command user interface and GUI means graphical user interface. Let's see what is CUI. CUI, the command user interface is the environment in which the operator interact with the computer through commands which are typed through keyboard. Presently, command user interface is not used in the most of the personal computer, and GUI, graphical user interface, in this operating system you need not remember the command. You can perform the task just by clicking on the option available. It is graphics based operating system. So it is called as graphical user interface. The most popular GUI operating systems are Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10, etc. Next we will learn here single user operating system. There are two type of operating system, single user operating system and multi user operating system. Single user operating system means a single user operating system has a single CPU and one set of input output devices. It supports only one user at a time. It supports only one user at a time. But multi user operating system means a multi user operating system allows more than one user to work on it. Each user works on different set of programs and data. In page number 24, here see your knowledge corner. A server is the computer that provides services to the other computers or devices. It may be a single CPU that execute several programs at once. And page number 25, given there, Windows 8 as an operating system. When you switch on your computer, it displays a screen showing Windows 8 depending upon the type of operating system. For a few seconds after some time, the first screen appears with the number of application icons along with the small graphic symbol known as start screen. I will discuss later. That page number 26. Just open page number 26. Wait. Page number 26. We will start here. Desktops and its components. Desktop and its components. Desktop and its components means that which are helping to the computer. Components, I will also discuss about this one. As soon as you start the computer system, the first screen that appears is called a start screen. Now you need to click on this desktop app that shows all the icons of the desktop. The word desktop has been derived from the word desk. Next, we will see here about the components. How many types of the components of the computer? How many types of the components of the desktop? Such like as icons here, taskbar, wallpapers, screen saver, personalized, means of customized. These are the components of the desktop. So I will discuss about some components of the computer. That is icons. Icons is a small picture on desktop, a small graphics picture on desktop. That is the icons. And here so many things are given there. Arranging icon on the desktop. They are given option to arrange the icons like that, by name, by size, by item type, by date modified, and different type of view. How we can view so many different type of the views is the large icons, medium icons, small icons, so many things there. And one more thing, we can hide the icons from desktop. How to hide icons from the desktop? That is also given that page number 27. The systems displays all the icons and folders which are essentially needed. However, the user may hide these icons depending upon the requirement. So you have to follow steps are given there. That's follow the steps and you can use this one. And next, taskbar. What is taskbar? It is present at the bottom of the desktop screen. It usually contains all the applications, time and shortcut button for the opening some programs. Taskbar is present at the bottom of the screen, bottom of the desktop screen. And next, wallpaper. What is the wallpaper? So wallpaper, the desktop of Windows is generally covered with a beautiful picture known as the wallpaper. The background, we can also say the background of the desktop. The background of the desktop is called wallpapers. Now the page number 31. Screen saver. What is a screen saver? Suppose your computer is idle. Idle means wait. Your screen is waiting for, you are not working at that time. Your computer is idle for some time and you might have noticed that some graphics appear on the screen. This moving graphics is known as a screen saver. Screen saver, whatever may be, can be a screen saver. Your picture also, some bubbles also, some waterfall also, like that. A screen saver is coming after the idle for some time your computer. And how to use a screen saver, given there some steps, page number 31 and 32. So you can use by this one also. Personalize your wallpaper. Personalize your wallpapers means that you can customize yourself. What I have given to the pictures, you can go through the drawing paint, you can use whatever you want. Finally, turn the page number 34. We will see here shutdown. What is the meaning of shutdown. Shutdown means we are going to switch off the computer. We are going to switch off the computer. There are two or three options are given there. Shut for shutdown. Here also move your mouse pointer to the right hand corner of the screen and select settings from the available options. Select a click power followed by shutdown from the list. In this page number, you have to read and you have to follow the three steps for this one, how to shut down your computer. This is the end task of the computer system. This task should be performed after completion of your work, of your task. This command helps you close down the computer system according to the different modes available. Perform these steps. Follow these steps and you can shut down your computer. Thank you. That's all.